Okay, if I could ask members who are leaving the chamber to do so as quickly and as quietly as possible, and we'll move on to the next item of business, which is an urgent question, and I call on Mark Griffin.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. To ask the Scottish Government what action it has taken to help agree a pay deal that is acceptable to council and education workers in order to avert industrial action.
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I thank the member for that question. The member will know, as I said before, that local government pay negotiations are between the trade unions and COSLA through the Scottish Joint Committee. The Scottish Government is not a member of the SJC, has never taken part in these negotiations, although I am very clear that a resolution which is suitable for all sides and avoids industrial action is in all of our best interests.
Mark Griffin.
Thank the Cabinet Secretary for that answer. Over half of local government workers earn below £25,000 a year, and the current offer doesn't even bring the lowest paid up to £10 per hour. And given the trailed uplift of the national minimum wage, does the Cabinet Secretary believe it's right that these workers are paid barely above that minimum hourly rate set by a Tory Chancellor? And the Scottish Government have intervened in pay negotiations for NHS workers and teachers, despite not being direct employers. Will the Cabinet Secretary then commit to intervening in this dispute, meet with the trade unions as requested, and fund a pay offer which puts local government workers on a par with their fellow NHS key workers?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I thank the member again for that question and recognise the position behind his question. I have frequently put my gratitude on record for our public sector workers, including those who work in local government, and we have reflected that position in the public sector pay policy, and that is in sharp contrast, as he says, with the pay freeze south of the border. Our public sector pay policy maintains the distinctive Scottish approach and continues with our focus on reducing inequalities. We have continued to do everything that we can to ensure that there is a fair settlement for local authorities, despite the challenges of the pandemic and the constrained fiscal position. I will continue to engage and would hope that progress can be made to avert industrial action, but also to ensure that there is a fair pay deal.
For the supplementary, Mark Griffin.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. How does the Cabinet Secretary believe we can keep schools open and safe in the middle of a pandemic with no cleansing, catering or janitorial staff because I've had no pay left at all for the duration of the pandemic? Notice for industrial action on the 8th to the 12th of November has been served, but that could just be the beginning of a long winter of school closures and waste or recycling not being collected. Our children's education has been severely impacted by the pandemic. What will the Scottish Government do to intervene in this dispute and keep schools open?
Cabinet Secretary.
Well, I meet with COSLA on a regular basis when it comes to the funding settlement for local authorities. I am continuing to do that in advance of next year's budget. So the point he makes about providing reassurance and providing certainty to local government is something that I believe in. I go back to my original answer, which is recognising how critically important our frontline workers are, recognising the importance of a pay deal that reflects the work they have done, which is why the Scottish Government's public sector pay deal is distinctive. It is far fairer than south of the border, despite there being no consequentials for that. And I sincerely hope that a resolution is found through the SJC, which is obviously based on negotiations between the trade unions and COSLA.